bibliko. Haleluya!
Haleluya jeunesse.
Hejuru dushire twa tuntu twacu.
No mushobora
kimana.
Pour la gloire de Dieu.
Haleluya!
Haleluya!
Kanyaganyeza kubukibera kimana.
Fais le trembler. Kibera kimana
munzu yayo.
La gloire de Dieu dans son temple.
Dans son
temple. La gloire de Dieu dans son temple.
Mazu tere hejuru nakaruru kenshi. Kubekibera kimana.
Haleluya!
Praise God.
Merci beaucoup.
Salut
ton voisin de gauche et de droite.
Yeah.
Amen.
Sans
plus tarder,
vous savez,
je vais te demander en acclamant
et ton élevé accueillant
notre papa, l'apôtre Masasu.
Welcome, papa.
Vous êtes la bienvenue, papa.
Alléluia.
Alléluia.
Ah, the glory of young man.
Et la gloire de cet homme.
The glory of the young man.
La gloire des jeunes gens.
Is their strength.
C'est leur force.
I said the glory of the young man is their strength.
J'ai dit que la gloire d'un jeune homme c'est sa force.
And the glory of the old man is their gray hair.
Et la gloire des gens qui ont vieilli c'est leurs cheveux blancs.
Tonight I wanna see the young men shouting amen.
Aujourd'hui, je veux voir les jeunes gens qui disent amen.
Oh my God! Woo! You're shatter.
Shit, c'est possible.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Oh, you know.
Vous savez.
Without wasting time.
Sans plus tarder.
Because we're supposed to start by 11 already in a fire.
Parce que nous sommes censés commencer à 23 heures.
When I get in, I feel the fire.
Quand je suis entré, j'ai senti le feu.
Ooh, my God.
Seigneur.
So I pass my microphone.
Je vais passer le micro
to the prophet.
Au prophète.
So big thank you, the clap for the Lord.
Acclamez le Seigneur.
Give the Lord Jesus a better clap offering. Give Jesus a better clap offering. You can do it better than that. You can do it better than that. Oh, shout hallelujah. The Bible says, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with the voice of celebration. Let me hear you shout. Let me hear you shout.
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 Woo!
Glory! Glory! Glory!
It's your way, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Will you please take your seat?
To show what a creature.
It's an honor to be part of this youth.
N'ibyicubahiro kuba umwe muri mwebwe urubyiruko muri iri joro ry'urubyiruko.
At the invite of your father.
Kubw'ubutumire bw'umubyeyi wanyu.
And my friend.
Kandi inshuti yanjye.
Apostle.
Umushyitsi intumwa.
Joshua.
Joshua.
Put your hands together for him.
Reka mukomere kandi Imana amashi.
See you.
Kubabona.
I know he believes in young people.
Ndabizi yuko yizera urubyiruko.
Ah, you didn't say amen. I said, see you.
Ndavuga ni kubabona.
I know your father believes in young
Ndabizi
people.
Ndabizi yuko urumubyeyi wanyu yizera mu rubyiruko.
Because there are pastors who don't believe in young
Kubera
people.
Kubera ko hari abashumba batizera urubyiruko.
If you are a pastor and you don't believe in young people, you don't have a future.
Kandi urumushumba utizera urubyiruko nta hejo hawe hazaza bahari.
So you have a father who believes in young people.
Rero mufite umubyeyi wizera urubyiruko.
So there is a future.
Rero ejo hazaza harahari.
Amen.
Amen.
I wish I could talk on spiritual fathers and sons.
Ndifuza ko twavuga hejuru y'isano y'umubyeyi n'umwana w'umwuka.
This is one of my books.
If you
don't have a father, you lack direction.
If you
don't have a father, you lack guidance.
If you don't have
a spiritual father, you lack identity.
And
so you need to understand fatherhood. And what sons are. In the spirit, we don't have sons and daughters. In the spirit, we are all sons of God. Because in Christ Jesus, there is neither male nor female. We are all one in Christ. And you see, as a young person gathered here, I want you to understand that you are not here by mistake.
Because
you are on God's timetable. Hey, tonight, where you should say amen. Give me
amen.
A young amen. Otherwise, I'll leave your youth pastor to come and preach because when I was sitting down, he almost preached everything. Put your hands together for him. He was with Apostle in Ghana. But as a young person, it's very important to understand that you are on God's timetable. It's not by mistake that you are young. God has a plan and a purpose for your life. In Acts chapter 2, on the day of Pentecost, Peter said, this is that which was spoken by the prophet John.
Well,
that it shall come to pass in the last days. If in the days of Peter was the last days, then you and I live in the last of the last days. He said it will come to pass in the last days that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and daughters shall prophesy. I came tonight to tell somebody there is an anointing to prophesy upon your life. You see, when the Bible says your sons and daughters shall prophesy, it means your sons and daughters will speak the mind and the will and the purposes of God. I came to tell you that you have the word of God in your mouth. I said, give me a young man's amen. You are on God's agenda. He said he will pour his spirit upon all flesh, young men and women. Young men and women includes you.
No,
you see, unfortunately, for so long, the Church of Jesus Christ has stood on one leg. The leg of only the man. Thank God. ERC, you are not like that. You have lady pastors. You have ladies who are ministering the word. Because the same Holy Spirit the men receive is the same Holy Spirit that women receive. When the Holy Spirit comes into a man, it is the same Holy Spirit that comes into a woman. When the Holy Spirit is coming into a woman, he doesn't leave his legs and his hands behind. He doesn't leave his mouth behind. He comes into a woman just like he comes into a man. I came to speak to some young man and woman tonight that God wants to use you.
kugukoresha.
You didn't give me an amen.
Ese mwavuga amen.
I said God wants to use you.
Navuze ngo Imana irashaka kubakoresha.
Put your hands together for mama.
Reka dukomere Imana amashyi kubwa mama.
Amen.
Amen.
Beloved, God wants to use you.
Imana irashaka kugukoresha.
You are not here by mistake.
Ntabwo uri hano kubwa impanuka.
You are here by God's plan.
Uri hano kubwa umugambi
w'Imana. And his purpose.
Kandi
hari intego. The future of this ministry.
Kubera ko ejo hazaza w'uyu
murimo. Is dependent on you.
Wiraterwa namwe.
And that is why tonight.
Ninayo mpamvu uyu mugoroba.
You must catch some fresh fire.
Ukeneye kwakira gukwakira ikiva ku mubyeyi.
Some fresh fire.
Ndavuze ni kwakira umuriro mushya.
The fire you had before
umuriro mwari mufite ubushize
is too old
uwo ngo urashaje
for what God is about to do
ariko ibyo birashaje kurusha ibyo Imana igiye gukora.
You are entering your new season
kuko muri kwinjira mu bindi bihe bishya
of your next week
ibishya
cyumweru gishya the next 7 years
indi myaka irindwi
the anointing of yesterday
hari amavuta y'Yesu
is too old for what God is about to do
ayo ngo yarashaje kubyo Imana igiye gukora.
That is why you must catch fresh fire
iyo mpamvu kene kwakira umuriro mushya.
In the book of 1 Samuel
mu gitabo cya Samweli wa
mbere, the Bible tells us
Bibiliya iratubwira ngo
that when Anna gave birth to Samuel
Anna maze kwibaruka Samweli
Anna took Samuel to Eli's house
Samweli Anna Imani muki
and when Anna took Samuel to Eli's house
maze imujyana mu nzu ya Eli.
My Bible says
Bibiliya irambwira ngo
every year
maze buri mwaka
new garments
buri mwaka yazanaga umwitero mushya kubwa Samweli
because the old clothes of Samuel
kubera ko umwenda mushya kuri Samweli
were too old
umwenda wabaga umwenda
for the new Samuel
ushaje kubwa ibihe bishya.
I came to tell somebody
naje kubwira umuntu
the anointing of it. You see, when we talk about clothes or garments,
murabizyo turi kuvuga umwitero umwambaro mushya,
it represents the anointing,
bibisobanura amavuta,
the anointing of yesterday,
hari amavuta y'ejo,
the anointing that you used to walk in before,
hari amavuta mwari musanzwe mukoreramo,
that anointing is too old,
ariko ayo mavuta arashaje.
Tonight
uyu munsi
you are catching a new anointing,
uyu murafata andi mavuta mashya. Amen.
You didn't hear me. I said tonight, you are catching a new anointing. I came with fresh clothes for you. Did you hear me? Listen to me. When Elijah was about to go to heaven, Elisha said, I want a double portion of your anointing or of your spirit. But when Elijah was going, he didn't lay hands on Elisha. What he did, he left his clothes for Elisha. I said, the anointing of yesterday of your past 7 years is too old to carry you into what God is about to do. And God sent me this to come and prophesy into somebody's life that you are entering a new season with new clothes, with a new garment, with new authority, with new power. Do you know that God is very interested in young men? One day my Bible says that there was war between Israel and the Philistines. And every day a giant will come out. His name was Goliath. And he will stand. And he will shout. And he will talk. And say that, get me somebody. Let him come and challenge me. All the old men were afraid. There was a young man who had the spirit of God. There was a young man who had the anointing of God, the same thing that the king
And the old men had were and were afraid. That same thing. A young man whose name was David heard and said, wow, this man is so big. When I get him and I take my stone, I will not miss him. I came tonight to tell somebody that God, my God, is bringing an anointing on some young man and some young woman who will do exploits in Jesus' name. Lift your hand and shout
hallelujah.
I know some of you, you are saying, well, but it talks about a young man. It doesn't talk about a young woman. My Bible says there was a general. His name was
Naaman.
He was a Syrian general. The Bible says he was a Syrian general. And the Bible says, but he was a leper. Everybody has got a but. Whatever your but is tonight, God is about to take care of your but. I said God is about to take care of your butt. Lift your hand and shout yes. He was an army general. But there was something missing. And my Bible says there was a young girl in the last days. I will pour my spirit upon your sons and daughters. There was a young girl in the house of
Naaman.
What everybody was afraid to say, she wasn't afraid to say. She went to the madam of the house and said,
Mama,
if only our father was in the land of Israel, there is a prophet there. She was ready to show the way. I came to tell you, sister, it would take you. Oh, you didn't hear me. I said, my sister, it will take you. My daughter, it will take you. For some of you, you are my daughter. Amen.
Amen.
Because my son, my firstborn, is a medical doctor. My secondborn is this one. My third child is a... it's a lawyer. She has qualified as a lawyer in UK. And then my fourth one.
No,
in the university. So you are some of you, you are qualified to be my daughter. So I came tonight to speak to you, my daughter. I came tonight to speak to you, my sister. That you are in the plan of God. I said you are in the plan of God. Amen.
Amen.
It took the young girl to tell Naaman, the wife, that there is a prophet. You know, there are times we say that, as for me, I am discouraged. My father died. My mother died. I don't live with my parents. I am adopted. And so God cannot use me. I am disadvantaged. So God cannot use me. This young girl, she had been captured and brought into Syria.
she was a maid.
Kandi yari umukarago.
If there was anybody who was disadvantaged,
and
who God could not use, it was that girl.
But
instead of sitting in her excuses, because a lot of the times we have a lot of excuses, we give excuses why God cannot use us. This girl did not care. This girl does not care. She remembered that if God could speak through a donkey, God can speak through a man. You didn't hear me. If God could speak through a donkey, God could speak through a man. I came to announce to you, if God can use anybody, God can use you.
Imana yagukoresha.
And so this girl, through her, a great miracle was wrought. I can see with the eye of faith some young girls making themselves available for God to use. I can see some young girls rising to be pastors, rising to be evangelists, rising to be bishops, rising to be apostles. I can see some young girls rising to be business women, rising to be lawyers, doctors, engineers. Receive that in Jesus' name. You know, 35 years ago, I was a bad boy. 35 years ago, I was a bad boy. I was chasing girls left, center, right. Then I met this girl. I wanted to go out with her. She said, my boyfriend is Jesus Christ. At that time, I was a practicing Nichiren Shoshu Buddhist. Practicing Nichiren Shoshu. Nichiren Shoshu is a form of Buddhism from Japan. It's called Nichiren Shoshu. Say it, let me see. Nichiren Shoshu. Nichiren Shoshu.
Nichiren Shoshu.
Good. It's called Nichiren Shoshu. Nichiren Shoshu Buddhism. I was a practicing Buddhist. And for me, I thought that Jesus Christ, according to Buddhist writings, it's one of the masters who come in every generation.
Kandi kuri njewe iryo dini ryasaga nk'irya kumera nk'irya ba Buddhist bambwiraga ko Yesu Kristo ari umwe muntu umwe gusa zoherejwe.
So when this girl said her boyfriend was Jesus,
no umukobwa ambwiye ngo ishuti yanjye ni Yesu,
and that if she would introduce me to her boyfriend,
kandi ko ashaka kunyereka umukunzi we,
she will go out with me.
Yuko aribuza ataza kunyemera gusokana nawe.
For me it was a joke.
Kuri njewe byasaga nk'aho ari ugukina.
Remember that night, high on marijuana. I had smoked marijuana.
You know,
amazingly, Indian hemp. You know, Indian hemp, marijuana or marijuana, how do you call it?
Okay, yangwaga urumogi.
Amen. Put your hands together for the lady. That night, I had smoked marijuana. I was high. And I walked into the church. And when I walked into the church, this was how I walked.
Aha, namwe murabyumva. Namwe murabyumva.
Surprisingly,
mubitangaje rero,
when people get high,
iyo abantu bari hejuru,
they walk as if they have one short leg.
Bisa nkaho urutugu rumwe rwavunitse.
You see, the devil is a liar.
Murabizi Satani
n'umunyabinyoma. The devil is a bad devil.
Satani n'umunyabinyoma.
But you see, you and I,
ariko jewe nawe,
when we get high on the power of the Holy Ghost,
ariko twazamutse,
we walk normally.
Tugenda neza.
We act normally.
Tugenda neza.
We sing in the Lord.
Turirimba neza
mu Mwami. We win souls.
Tuzana abantu kuri Kristo. Twirukana amadayimoni.
Ah, my God. That night,
I was high on marijuana. So I walked. And I sat at the back of the church. And I was waiting for the service to close. And I would go with this girl. And then the preacher preached. I don't remember what he said. But one thing I remember. For the first time in my life. He said, if you want to give your life to Jesus. Come to the front. And I walked to the front. And I raised my hands and I accepted Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior. From that day, the power of drugs, alcohol, tobacco, womanizing broke from my life. Before that day, I couldn't stay 2 weeks without having a girlfriend or having sex. When I got saved, I stayed 5 years without knowing a woman. Then I got married to my wife. We've been married for 30 years. In the 30 years, my wife is the only woman I have kissed. When God saves you, He saves you to the uttermost. I came today to tell somebody, God is about to do something in your life. If you can hear me, say hallelujah. Listen to me. Today, because of a young lady, I have traveled to 110 countries and preached in 84 of them. Because a young lady was willing to introduce me to her boyfriend, who was Jesus. I came tonight to say to you, my sister, there is an anointing coming upon you today. You didn't give me an amen. I said there is an anointing coming upon you today. Young man, there is an anointing coming upon you. You see, for some of you, you think you have to be old for God to use you. When I got saved, 2.5 years after I got saved, I came into full-time ministry. God made me quit my job and come full-time when I was almost 21. I wasn't 21 yet. As a young man, I came to tell somebody, God wants to use you. You are not receiving it as young men and women. As for young men and women, you have life. Me, I'm younger than you. The way you are responding, I am younger than you. I said, as for young men and women, you respond your amen with life. Give me a young amen. When Caleb was 84 years old, he said, I am like when I was 40. Give me this mountain. As a young man, I started crusades. When I was 23 years old, my crusade was national news. It was in the newspaper. A journalist got the daughter healed and he published it in the newspaper.
23.
You don't have to be an old man for God to use you. I came to say to some young people, this is your season. This is your time. This is your season. Listen. And so it's a season to take responsibility. Tonight, I came to talk about taking responsibility. Say, taking responsibility. Amen.
Amen.
You know, there are times we like to check our responsibility. We like to say it is not my turn. We like to say it is not me. We like to say, I'm not the one supposed to do it. Listen.
If this church will go to the four corners of the earth,
don't look
at some old men. Look at
you.
I said, look at you. You are not giving me an amen. If this church will go to the four corners of the earth, don't look at some old men and women. Look at you. If the work of this church will be supported, it is not in the hands of young old men and women. It is in your hands. You have the future of this church. Give me an amen. Tell somebody sitting by you, you have the future of this church. And that means it is time for you to be responsible. And there is a chapter in my book on leadership.
15
key ingredients for effective leadership. I call it the power of responsibility. You have got to be responsible. It starts from now. As a young man or woman, never mispay your tithes. Because your tithes is the doorway to God's prosperity. Did you hear me? I said your tithes is the doorway to God's prosperity. So for a young man and woman, you must be faithful in your tithes. And listen to me. You have got to have a mentality that believes in money. Because without money, we can't spread the gospel. In Zechariah chapter 1, verse 17, the Bible says, my cities, yet through prosperity, shall spread abroad. Zechariah
1:17.
So if the church of God was spread, it will take prosperity. You must prosper. But you see, you can't prosper if you think prosperity is wrong. Are you here with me? If you think getting money is wrong, you can't prosper. You need to have a rich mentality. Because as a man thinketh, so is he. What you think is what you become. You remember that Jesus told the story of the Good Samaritan. He said there was a man who was going in the night. Armed robbers met him. They beat him, they wounded him, and they put him by the roadside. A priest was passing. He did nothing. A Levite was passing. He did nothing. A Samaritan was passing. He was riding a horse or a donkey. He did something. Listen. The priest could not do anything. The man had been attacked. If the priest wanted to carry him, armed robbers would meet them and beat them again. How far could he carry the man? If the Levite was to carry him, he was walking. How far will he go? When the Samaritan got there, he had a horse. He took the man. He put him on the horse. He took him to an inn. In those days, an inn or a hotel had a clinic. He took him to the clinic. When he took him there, my Bible says he gave him to the innkeeper and said, take care of him. This is money to take care of him. I will come back again. And if there is additional
more money to be paid, I will pay it. Listen to me. You can't be a good Samaritan if you don't have it.
You didn't hear me.
I said you can't be a good Samaritan if you don't have it. My people have a proverb. They say if nakedness, he doesn't have any clothes. If nakedness promises you a piece of clothes, listen to his name. His name is nakedness. How can he give you clothes? If you don't have it, you can't give what you don't have. Are you here with me? Peter said, such as I have, give I thee. In this life, you can only give what you have. Tell somebody you can give what you have. Your amen. And so as a young man, you have got to take responsibility. Start fighting. Not only must you fight. How many of you young men and women don't pay your tithes? Stand up, let me see. You don't tight. Stand up, let me see. Don't feel shy. Stand up.
You don't tight.
Stand up, let me see.
Haguruka.
Yes, thank you. Stand up. Yes.
Haguruka.
You don't tight. Stand.
Niba uziko ugifite ikibazo ihagurukire.
Because I'm going to pray forgiveness for you. Because if you don't tight, you are under a curse. And when you are under a curse, and you work, you don't get blessed. So if you don't tight, stand up. Let me pray forgiveness for you. Don't feel sad. You don't tight. Stand, let me pray for you. Look, when it comes to the kingdom of God, we enter individually. We don't enter as a group. So if you don't tight, stand. I'm going to pray with you. I'm going to pray forgiveness for you. Lift up one hand. If you don't tight, say this after me. Say, God,
mana,
tonight, I ask forgiveness for robbing you. From today, I promise to be faithful in my tithes and my offerings. Amen.
But amen.
Oh, give me an amen.
Amen.
Believe in amen. The Bible says, when we fight, God opens the windows of heaven for us and pours us out a blessing. Listen to me. I'm looking at the time that I'll visit this place and a young man that God has blessed, a young woman that God has blessed, will walk to the apostle and say, apostle, since I became a part of this ministry, God has blessed me. Take this bus for the church. I want to put up a church building in my hometown. Ah, that will be your story. Give me a believing amen.
It
says your young man shall see visions. What you see is what you get. If you don't see it, you don't get it. If you don't begin to see that God is blessing you, that God is prospering you for the kingdom of God, it's not going to happen. May you begin to see. Tell somebody, may you begin to see. Tell another person, may you begin to see. Amen.
Amen.
Listen to me. As a young man, I began to see myself preaching in India. Preaching
preaching around the world. I began to see it. So when I was praying, I could see it literally. It didn't take long for God to take me to the nations. Because what you see is what you get. Elijah said to the young man, if you see me go, it will happen to you. Tell your neighbor what you see is what you get. Listen. That is why it is very important. You came to this conference in this great auditorium for you to see that it is possible. If it has been done, you can do it. You didn't hear me. I said, if it has been done, you can do it. Are you here with me? You have an example. When we were growing up back in Africa, we didn't have examples of people who have built and done exploits like that. We had to pioneer. Thank God. You are seen. And because you have seen, you can do it. I said, because you have seen it, you can do it. But you have got to take responsibility that it is dependent on you. It is not somebody else. You have the responsibility to do it. Before I lead you to pray tonight, as a young man, 6 months in the Lord, we were in our local church. Small church. We were going to have an open air gospel preaching. And we had to go and dig the park and put poles. Light poles. And the young men in the church were supposed to meet at 3.
Kandi abashire mu itoro twagomba guhura saa 9.
We were supposed to meet at 12.
Twagomba guhura saa 6.
By 3 o'clock.
Saa 9.
Nobody had come.
I
was the only one. I was getting discouraged. I said to my pastor, look at the other young men, they are not coming. If they are not coming, I'll also go and sit down. And my pastor said something to me. He said, if your father had a shop, and every morning they have to open the shop for customers to come, and you have brothers and they won't go, will you say because your brothers will not go, you will not go? Something hit my spirit. I realized that the kingdom of God, if it will succeed, is dependent on me in my own small way. I have to be responsible. If nobody else is doing it, I must do it. It is my father's business. Jesus said, I must be about my father's business. As a young man and woman, I want you to catch this revelation and be responsible. When church should start at 6 or 7, you don't wait and come 6:30, because it's your father's business. If it's starting at 7, you have to be there 6:30 to make sure everything is in order before other people will come. You have to be responsible. Tell somebody, be responsible. Tell another person, be responsible. Oh, somebody is clapping. If somebody is clapping, we should all clap. Put your hands together. Listen to me. If you will be responsible, if she will be responsible, if he will be responsible, and we all bring our activities together, what a church we will have. Listen to me, beloved. Tonight I came to put in your spirit that God still wants to use young men and women
those who want to be, who want to feel responsible, they are responsible. They know that if this church will spread, it is through them. If this church, will put up church buildings, it is through them. If we have some young men and women who catch that vision, I tell you, nothing will stop us. Did you hear me? I said nothing will stop us. I said nothing will stop us. You know the Bible, when they were going to choose deacons in the church, in Acts chapter 6, they said, let us choose some young men who are God fearing and full of wisdom. Some young people, God fearing, full of wisdom. Can we have some young people fearing God, full of wisdom, filled with the Spirit of God, to do things for the kingdom of God? Because listen to me, the work of evangelism is the responsibility of young people. Did you hear me? The work of intercession is the responsibility of young people. When I was a young man, I was doing 3 days all nights in a week. 3 days all nights in a week. In our church, we had an all night for the whole church. And then we had one for the youth. And then I had my personal one. Saturday evening, I will pray at least 6 hours. And so Sunday when I went to church, and my pastor, he was very intellectual. So when he preached, I didn't even understand. And a lot of us in the church, we didn't understand what he was preaching. But when he made the altar call, people will be coming from everywhere. And I'll be shaking my leg and saying in my heart, this is part of my prayer. This is part of my prayer. Because I was interceding, I saw it as a responsibility. God is looking for some young men and women. I started our church when I was 25 years old. Peres Chapel. Started when I was 25 years old. Today we are in 16 nations of the world. The work started by a 25-year-old. Amen.
Amen.
In Ghana, in my city, in Accra, we have 54 branches.
Muri Ghana, muri Accra, dufite ama branches cyangwa paruwasi 54.
The work started by a young man.
Are
you understanding what I'm talking about? So I came to say to some young man and woman, it is time you felt responsible. Tell somebody, feel responsible. Hey, you are not talking like it. I said, say to somebody, feel responsible. Will you be on your feet? Will you stand? We are going to pray. We are going to pray. You are going to ask God. God,
Mana,
the man of God, said, for a young man, I should be responsible. For a young woman, I should be responsible. The future of this church is dependent on me. God, anoint me, enlarge my coast, grant me a bigger vision, let me see like I have never seen. Open your mouth, talk to God. Open your mouth, talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to Him. Talk to Him. Open your mouth, talk to God. 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 Open your mouth, talk to God. Open your mouth, talk to God. 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 Give Jones a microphone for me. No, no, no.
Give Jones a microphone for me to back me. Talk to God. Open your mouth. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Maka shatatata. Riba shataka. Open your mouth. Talk to God. 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 Help back me. Talk to God. Open your mouth. Talk to God. Talk to God. Take your microphone. Give them volume for me. Yes, talk to God. Open your mouth. Talk to God. God, I come to you. Enlarge my coast. Enlarge my coast. Enlarge my coast. Talk to God. Enlarge my coast. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to him. 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 Open your mouth. Talk to God. Talk to him. Talk to him. He shall anoint you. Talk to God. Talk to God. He shall anoint you. He shall anoint you. He shall anoint you. He shall anoint you. Yes, he shall open your eyes to see. What you see is what you get. It's too old for today. Talk to God. Talk to him tonight. Talk to him. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to him. Talk to him. Open your mouth and talk to God. Talk to him. God must use you. God must use you. God must use you. God must use you. Talk to God. Talk to him.
Of your spirit.
Not of the Holy Spirit. He said, I want a double portion of your spirit. The Bible says, God took of the spirit that was upon Moses and put it on the 70. When God calls a man, he anoints him. And then he causes the spirit to rest upon him. And by that spirit upon him, he does a work. This morning, we are going to pray. You are going to pray that God, your servant Apostle Masasu, you sent him as our prophet. I want the spirit upon him to come upon me. So that God, the plan and purpose for our generation will be fulfilled. You want that spirit. You want that spirit. Open your mouth. Talk to God. Take off his spirit. God should take off his spirit. Bring it upon you. There should be a transference. There should be a transference. There should be a transference. That spirit of breakthrough. That spirit of favor. Talk to God. That spirit of open doors. That's great.
Sakataka satakata sando baya patelele sakata langrukote fata baba sakata prophet, release the word
bifate
sokotu Brakata Saka, Sandeba Kappa, Sukotokoba, Landorobayapa, Sakatokote, Sandabaya Pakate, Sakatolo Katalaba, Randoroba Siaba, Fata Kalebo Sekete, Sandaba Kapata, Sakatele, Sanderebo, Sakati, Sakata. Now,
no, Naha.
Lift up your hands together.
Some
the bishop will release the anointing for missions. With that spirit, you're gonna go. You're gonna go to the corner of the world.
Oh,
hallelujah. Get ready.
Nitegure.
Get ready.
Itegure.
Heavenly Father.
Data
can you increase the volume? For Heavenly Father.
Data.
All people are being anointed with the gifts of healing.
84.
Take it now. Take it now. 84 people. Gifts of healing. Working of miracles. It's happening. On my right. Those on my right. Receive the anointing. Now. Receive it.
Achira. Achira.
Take it.
Achira. Achira.
Now.
No, naha.
Get ready. From the front,
Hanimbere.
There is an anointing coming from the platform. From the front,
Aturukimbere.
Get ready.
Itegure.
Receive the anointing.
Achira.
No.
Nonaha.
Receive it.
Achira. Nonaha. Nonaha.
Shaka. Shaka tala brokoto. Yokes are breaking. Your yokes are breaking.
Yeah.
So that you can serve him. Yes, 58 people are receiving their deliverance now. They are receiving their deliverance now.
Oh.
54 people. You sleep.
Achira.
Somebody is sleeping with you. You are being set free. There is a power encounter. Because God is anointing you for service. Receive the anointing. Receive your liberty.
Now.
Some young men and women are receiving a fresh anointing.
Receive it
right now.
Get
it. It's yours. Take it. Second touch. Second touch. Fire.
Muriro.
Fire.
Muriro.
Holy fire.
Muriro.
From above. Godly one. Receive it.
Muriro wima.
Sakati. Receive it.
Shabira.
Receive it.
Achira.
Receive it.
Achira.
Yes.
Rakat.
Achira. The winds of God.
Sakato.
The winds of God.
Blow
now. Thank you, Lord.
Urakoze.
Katele.
Wachire.
Sokoto. Black.
We give you praise.
Wachire.
We give you praise.
Wachire. Sanglo makatala.
Wachire. Wachire.
We give you praise. Take it. It's your portion. It's yours.
We give you praise.
The second touch is yours.
We give you praise.
That's in your car. Yes.
Take it. Fire. Umuriro. Umuriro.
Fire.
Umuriro.
Maka tuku. Maka tuku. Lebru. Shut.
Listen.
Those of you who are still standing in front, join your two hands like I've joined the apostles. Join your two hands like that and lift it up. lift it up. Join your two hands, those of you in front.
That's the way.
Listen to me. I said, join your two hands. There is an anointing that is going to go through your hands. Don't break the chain. Join your two hands.
Muhindukire murebe aho bari. Muhindukire hariya. Mureba hariya. Abari imbere mwese murebe hariya.
Listen.
Brakata kashaka. Ya.
Listen. There is an anointing that is going to flow from the front to the back. The two of us, we are going to touch the first person in front. That anointing will flow to the back. Receive it now. Take it. Receive it. Don't stop them. Receive the anointing. Yes. Take it. I said, touch the person in front. Put your hand on the person in front, on the shoulder. Put your hand on the shoulder. Just one hand. Are you ready? Get ready. Yes. Yes. Receive it. Yes. Receive it. Receive it.
Up to back.
Glory to Jesus. We give you praise. We give you praise.
Connect.
We give you praise. Ushers, don't catch them yet. Let God work on them. God is working on them. Are you ready? Receive it. Yes. Receive it. Yes. We give you praise. Lord, we give you praise. We love you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise.